how files on demand affects recovering OneDrive files. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I had just mistakenly deleted some files from my OneDrive account that I could not retrieve. Luckily, I have a PC that have been taken offline from the internet for over a year that has those files, though they may not be current, that I would like to copy back to my OneDrive account. I do not want to reconnect this PC to the internet and sync the files, afraid that the files will be lost as the local OneDrive folder is syncing with the online folder. I could not cut and paste the files from the old PC onto a USB drive due to an error code. I searched this error code up and found that the cloud server is not running. All the files on the old PC also have a gray X at the lower left corner of their icons. Do you have recommendations allowing me to safely copy those files to an external USB drive so that I can take another PC with internet connection and update the online OneDrive folder? Greatly appreciate your help. Well, you may rethink that appreciation here in a moment. I do have a straw to grasp at, but I'm pretty sure it won't involve the other PC. I'll describe why that is, since it's an incredibly important concept for backing up the contents of your OneDrive. The straw I'm going to have you grasp at is the recycle bin in OneDrive. Now, let's take a look here on in my Windows 11. I'm going to go ahead and head over to OneDrive.com, and you can see that Windows 11 has a recycle bin. That's not the one I'm talking about. The one I'm talking about is over here in OneDrive.com online. That's the online repository of your files in the cloud. When you delete something, even if you delete it on your PC, online that file is moved to the recycle bin. So if you click on it, you would see a list of files. Obviously, I just have the one here for my example account, but you would see the original location, the date it was deleted, and so forth. You can then restore the file to its original location. In fact, that's the option, restore, or you can completely delete it if you want to. So the straw for you to grasp at is to immediately, as quickly as possible, go to this online OneDrive.com recycle bin and see if the file you're looking for is there. If it is, restore it, count your blessings, because you're done. Before we look at what's happened, I suspect, to your files, we need to understand a couple of concepts about how OneDrive deals with disk space. It's actually not uncommon these days for someone's OneDrive to contain more data than their computer actually has room for. For example, if my OneDrive has 500 gigabytes of stuff in it, maybe it's photos or something like that, but my computer has only 200 gigabytes of available space, that's a problem. If I fully sync OneDrive, well, it's going to fill up the hard disk and then fail to synchronize the rest. OneDrive has two solutions to this problem. Choose folders and files on demand. Choose folders allows you to completely hide a folder from within your OneDrive from a particular PC. We'll have a quick look at that. It doesn't really relate to the problem at hand, but I at least want to point it out to you because it is an important setting. So we'll look at OneDrive settings. And here in the account tab, you'll see that there's this item that says choose folders. If I click on choose folders, it will actually bring up a list of all the top level folders that are in my OneDrive. Those folders with a check mark are visible on the PC, and their contents may take up space on the PC. Conversely, if you uncheck something, like if I uncheck the secured in Cryptomator vault or folder and click on OK, that folder remains online. You can see here that it is still there, secured in Cryptomator. But if I fire up Windows File Explorer and take a look at my personal OneDrive, that folder's not there. To the PC, it's as if this folder doesn't exist, even though it still does exist in the cloud. So that's one way. For example, what I would do if I had, say, 500 gigabytes of stuff in my OneDrive and 450 gigabytes of that was photos in a photos folder, I might choose not to make that folder visible on my PC at all so that I can then safely download the other stuff in the available space. Like I said, this feature doesn't really apply to our situation here. Files on demand, on the other hand, absolutely does. Now, in order to understand files on demand, we need to take a look at files. For purposes of this discussion, a file has two components. It has a name, the name you call the file, and in fact, if I take a look at my Word documents, you can see that I have three files here. They are called Test Example 1, Test Example 2, and Test Example 3. The data is the contents of your document. For example, if I've written the next great novel and saved it in Test Example 1, then the contents of Test Example 1, the data, would be my novel. Now, in a nutshell, files on demand means the file's names are always shown in your OneDrive folder on your PC. The file's data, on the other hand, is not downloaded to your PC until you need it. Typically, that means it's downloaded if you try to open the file. So when you are running the OneDrive application, then OneDrive will put signs or status symbols on the icons for your files. For example, right here in front of us, Test Example 2 has a check mark in a solid green circle. If I hover the mouse pointer over its name, you can see that one of the pieces of information there is availability status always available on this device. That means that the data for this file has been downloaded and it won't get cleaned up if need be. That file will always be on the PC in its entirety, like any other file. Now, the other scenario that's common, I'll hover over Test Example 1, you can see that it's got a cloud icon. In this case, the availability status is available when online. What that means is that the data for that file does not exist on this PC. The file name does, but the data does not. The first time we try to use the file, for example, if I were to double-click on it and open it, you'll see that the icon has changed to a circled checkmark. And the download status has said available on this device. Not always available, just available on this device. That means the file was an on-demand file and its data was downloaded because we tried to use it. Now, there are two other status icons or status symbols that can appear on these icons. One is the very familiar two arrows chasing each other in a circle. That means that the file is either currently being synchronized with OneDrive in the cloud, or it needs to be synchronized with OneDrive in the cloud. If you were to, for example, attempt to download a dozen files all at once, OneDrive's going to do those one or two at a time. So the status will show it downloading, but the rest will still show the circled arrows indicating that they are about to or should be downloaded. And finally, there's the X that you saw. But with the X, that indicates that the data has not been downloaded, but there's also a problem preventing it from being downloaded. Okay. So now we have this concept of a file name and its data being two different things. A file name will always be shown in OneDrive, and the data may or may not have been downloaded to your PC. Based on the symbols on the icons for those files, you can tell where they are. How do you control this mess? Well, it's actually not that difficult. First of all, we're going to take a look at controlling it globally. Once again, I'm going into OneDrive, hitting Settings, and this time I'm going into Sync and Backup, which is not what we're going to do, Advanced Settings, and then Down here is Files on Demand. There are two buttons here that control what happens. Free up disk space will remove the data from all of the files on your PC. The data will still be online, but they will all be changed to be on demand so that all of the disk space will get freed up. The names will still exist in File Explorer, but the data will not be taking up space. The first time you use that file, of course, the data will be downloaded because the data still exists in the cloud. The other button, Download All Files, is the exact opposite. It basically says, okay, we're going to download absolutely everything. That's as close as we can get to turning the on-demand feature off. All it really means is that as soon as you hit that button, OneDrive will start downloading all of the data for all of the files that haven't already been downloaded, and it will mark everything as being always available. Now, that's kind of an all or nothing kind of thing, right? We can download everything or we can remove the data for everything. As it turns out, you can't control on a file-by-file or folder-by-folder basis. If we go back to Windows File Explorer, if we take a look at these files now, like I said, we have these three states. Test Example 1 has its data downloaded and it's available on this PC. Test Example 2 has its data downloaded and it's always available on this PC. And Test Example 3 is a file name without data that has a cloud icon that means as soon as we try to use it, the data will be downloaded. We can change any of that. For example, I'm going to right-click on Test Example 3, and you'll see here that there are two options of interest. One is Always Keep on This Device, which is how you tell OneDrive to download the data for that file immediately and have it marked as Always Keep on This Device. The other, of course, is the opposite. If I right-click on it again and I say Free Up Space, the file is not deleted, but the data is removed from your PC. It still exists in the cloud, and if I were to open this file, the data would be downloaded again. That's how you control at the file-by-file level or the folder-by-folder level where this technique also works. All right, now we understand that files can be listed with data on your machine or listed with data not on your machine, but downloaded if you ask for it or if you try to use the file. Why does any of this matter? Well, if you want to copy a file from OneDrive on your PC to another location, perhaps another drive, or to back up the file, both that file's name and its data needs to actually be on your PC. If the file's data is not on your PC, then you must be connected to the internet with the OneDrive app running in order to download it. So if you try and copy like Test Example 3 in my example, if I were to copy it somewhere that is unrelated to OneDrive, OneDrive would first download the data and then copy the file. However, if you are not connected to the internet and the file's data is not on your PC, then you will be unable to download it. You will be unable to copy it. You will be unable to do much of anything with it because the data is not there. All right, finally, coming full circle. Now that we understand how all of these pieces work, let's take a look at the original question and address it more completely. Quote, I have a PC I've taken off from the internet for over a year that has those files, may not be current, that I would like to copy back to my OneDrive account. I did not want to reconnect this PC to the internet and sync the files, afraid that the files will be lost as the local OneDrive folder is syncing with the online folder. I could not cut and paste the files from the old PC onto a USB drive due to an error code. I searched this error code up and found that the cloud server is not running. All the files on this old PC also have a gray X at the lower left corner of their icons. The bad news here is that the files have already been lost. If they are not in OneDrive's recycle bin. Then, the files have been removed from the original computer where you deleted them. The files have been removed from OneDrive Online. That this old computer lists the files, but with a gray X, and that it's complaining about the cloud server not running, means that the files are on demand, meaning that the file's data is not stored on this older computer. The computer is trying to fetch the data, but it's having trouble doing so, probably because OneDrive is not connected. And even if OneDrive was connected, the files have been removed from OneDrive Online, so there is still nowhere to get the data from. I realize that this on-demand feature of OneDrive seems complicated. In a sense, it kind of is, and it has some ramifications that may not be obvious from the start. But hopefully now, understanding how the feature works, you'll understand what's needed to make sure that a file, the entire file, is actually present on your PC. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/173383. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.